See, all this is appliqué on. It's just cross-stitched on.
But you have colors in that, too. I thought you said it was one solid color, and then you embroidered
it.
No.
Well, I had a new tour book in that Virgin River place might be in each town.
I got that. But I think I better start off a little bit.
And they said, yeah, this person wants to locate here. We'll be around.
Yes. He wants to take it.
Oh, here comes Jackal.
Rotate.
Rotate.
Oh, we are. No, I don't.
Grannies and grandma's rule.
Discussing about, you know, what reactions other people have. Don't got a hold of him. I've had after 3 days of Jonah and his rebellious spirit. He had the worst stomachache.
Well, I was ready to throw up, wasn't he?
Yeah. Well, the other guy said, yeah, you had a belly full of...
A cushion sole, I see. Yeah.
With odor eaters.
We've got a couple of portable cordless.
We're up to
not the spray.
Grab the tri spoons on.
Let's see if I can switch. Manipulated. It's a speakerphone, too.
Yeah.
And it's an intercom.
She is a miss.
Who?
Schroeder. I pity Bill Clinton. He's too smart to make her his running mate. He won't have anything.
She's not going to
win. We
had
a big battle. Those two women.
Now to
Brent.
What's it for?
It's
Kevin.
Afghan for his college.
Make J.D. Power Associates.
Oh, that's that.
Did you take any lessons?
Lorraine, you never heard of music.
Homemade ice cream, Texas sheet cake, barbecued beef, nachos, orange salad.
Well, have you ever...
Oh, sad, isn't it?
Oh, see the baby. We got Jack. There's Matt and Dave.
Is that you?
Dave. And Jack is Dad and me. Where's Lorraine?
You're holding the baby.
Where's Lorraine? She should have been around somewhere. Probably running off with her girlfriends.
Is that her with the hands over her face?
There she is.
That's Lorraine in the red?
Uh-huh. She cute?
She's Dad's favorite daughter.
Yeah, you betcha. And Jack, look, he's just a tiny baby. Millie? Horton?
Yeah.
Carol? Yeah. She has...
That's Grace Community?
Yeah. Told you it was a church. I remember Jeannie for just a little while, but not much.
She was in first class, the credit.
There's Grandma Orr.
And Jenny Knight. Oh, that was Lucy.
Dad.
Yeah, that was Lucy.
Doesn't that look like Jack? That head?
I don't know. Well, the head.
He told me the other day he thought he looked like Daddy, and I didn't say, I said, nah.
Sure.
That oh, head? He does there.
Yeah, does look like Jack.
Yeah, from the side.
Jack really
there's sees. Steve. No, is that Jesus. Steve? No.
Steve who?
No. He's not that.
Big. Is he even born yet?
No, I... This is Jeannie opened gifts at her wedding.
You're sure holding one of the kids, Lorraine.
Had to be Jack. Because they were living up in this house, in the big house. Eugene.
That's Matt again?
I think it's Matt.
Yeah, I think
like
so too.
Toehead. There's a
Jeannie's shower, I bet.
I think so. Oh, it's G.A., yeah. Jeannie and G.A.
Look at how skinny. Boy, wouldn't it be nice? There's Beverly.
Elizabeth. Althea. There's Pete again. Grandma Orr.
Pete there?
Yeah, Pete's right ahead of her.
That's
Steve.
His brother. That's brother
That's
and sister.
That's her brother, uh-huh. But she was, say, 17 or 18 when he was born.
Yeah, there's a lot of difference between them. He uh-huh. died a long time before she did. There's uh-huh. Althea.
Was that Charles Hobson or Mr. Evers?
Or had two brothers, Uncle Char and Uncle Pete.
There's Char.
Is that Russell?
Marilee.
Who's with the glasses?
Althea there.
That's Aldi.
Yeah, it is Alden. Elizabeth.
Oh,
there's Grandma Orr.
Good yeah. picture of Grandma Orr.
That's Yale's mom.
Oh, and there's Char.
That's her brother.
Who is Aunt May?
Yeah, this is the other one.
Uncle Pete, yeah. That is good.
Look at that food.
Who was, oh, that's Dee. And then Elizabeth. Who was Aunt Maid?
That was Grandma's, the wife of Grandma's uncle.
Oh.
Uncle Char.
Who is
Mary
that?
There's
Dean.
Oh, now that is Elizabeth Knight's dad.
Pollock, Mr. Pollock.
Yeah.
That's Dean.
Who's his kids?
Yeah, who's that little
well,
girl?
I don't know who they were. Jeannie.
That's Jeannie.
See, who'd that be?
That's be
oh,
a knight.
Oh, I know who that is.
Isn't that Nancy's?
No, no,
who
no.
Who is that man? I don't remember
they're,
him.
That's
Oh, look at you,
Jenny's. Jenny's daughter. What's her name?
Margaret.
No, Jenny.
Wow.
Jenny Knight's daughter. What was her name? Myrtle. Those were Myrtle's.
Oh, is that what's her name?
Her boy and that's who that
see
was.
See Margaret, mom.
Yeah.
Huh? See Margaret.
Wasn't she young? She looked like a little girl.
There's Grandma
huh?
Orr. Look at all that food.
It's Lorraine.
Bob and
no,
Margaret,
Bob and Margaret.
They married.
Bob and Margaret.
Right now, I'm during that picture.
No. Yeah, they were.
Sure they were.
She doesn't want to get her picture taken either.
She hated pictures. Who is that?
I don't know who that is.
Must be relatives on their side. Now, see, Jeannie's wedding was out at
That's mother. That's my mother. And Aunt Paul, Aunt Edith.
Was it?
Yes.
This is at Jeannie's wedding out at the Butler. She had a garden wedding.
And I think that that guy that we were asking about right there is Mr. Mercer, Ralph Mercer.
Now watch, Grandma Doll. Yeah. There.
That's your mom?
Uh-huh, that's my mother, and there's Aunt Edith, her sister. Nancy's mom.
She was really...
There's Nancy.
She was really young.
Mary, Nancy, I don't know who the other one was, Tiny Lee, I guess.
That was older there.
Look at her.
Hort's time, these die.
Yeah, it's cute. He looks...
Look at him standing. They said when he saw these, he was so emotional.
Dean?
It really...
Who did?
See, Jeannie's, I remember that.
Pat, she said when Dean looked at these, he was so emotional.
Was he?
Well, he probably doesn't remember much of his dad.
That's the fence out in front of the house, son, Dad.
There's Nancy.
Yeah.
See all the old cars?
Oh, Beverly...
Beverly, I recognize her face, but...
Beverly
doesn't sound
and right. That was what?
One of Ord's friends.
Can you imagine all those people going out to the ranch
and
for a wedding?
And it was raining bloody murder in the rain. That was Mary Wyatt, honey.
There's Daddy, me? Yeah. Mr. Edwards.
Mary Wyatt. That isn't Yale, that.
Yes,
it is too.
That's me.
I don't think so.
Was.
Yes.
I bet that's Alan Wyatt.
Mother, that's Daddy.
Oh, that's me.
Mr. Edwards, huh? Mm-hmm.
Nancy.
Grandma Orr.
Yeah.
Dorothy, Bird.
Yeah, look at Bird.
He looks like
Millie.
Howard.
There's Beverly, all those friends.
There's Miss Dalton.
Yes, there's Miss Dalton.
And there's Jean, Frenchie Renew.
Yeah. That's
that, yeah, so she carried the kids that way. A lot of times, I remember.
That was Steve.
No, Steve's not born yet.
I mean,
yet.
Jack.
You looks like you're scraping your feet.
It was raining that day, cats and dogs.
Yeah.
Bruce. That was Bruce.
Who had the hat? Orange.
Char.
That is Stetson? Who?
Oh, that's Aunt Maud.
Yeah.
Who was Maud?
Aunt Louise Newton.
Yeah. See, now I went to school with Alice Newton.
She's had some bad experiences. These are probably...
Who, Alice or Louise?
Alice. She had a nervous breakdown was in the Colorado State Hospital for a while.
Was she?
Or she wiped the water off the chairs.
Yeah, it was. It just rained long enough to have that ceremony, and then it started again. I mean, it just quit long enough to have the ceremony. It rained hard.
They hauled all those chairs out there.
Hard before and hard afterwards.
They must have carried the piano out on the porch. Yeah. Who was singing?
Beverly. What did I tell you her name
oh,
was?
Oh, look
yet?
At...
She didn't tell me. I don't know.
Yes, I did.
I don't remember.
Now, who were her
Sorry,
flower girls?
Revis. Or not Revis, but... Well, Nancy Knight was one of them. I don't know.
No, Ord wasn't near
they
as bald as you were.
He had a lot of hair. There's one time... His hair started to grow again.
Mm. Yeah, that's when he had cancer. You know, just...
Okay, boy, right. G.A. looks young. Mm-hmm. Mr. Edwards married them, too. Was I pretty much some of the last ones that he married in the family?
Oh, okay. He performed a lot of marriages and ceremonies that, oh, in the family.
Before he died. How long had Marilee and Eugene been married?
Not long.
You're sure holding one of the kids, Lorraine.
Had to be this.
Boy, G8 looks young. Mr. Edwards married them, too. Was I pretty much some of the last ones that he married in the family?
Oh, then he performed a lot of marriages and ceremonies that, oh, in the family.
Bring that back?
Lorraine's
gonna... No.
See what you did? To the school. You and... Steve.
What did we? Are you? What did I fast forward it instead of rewind?
Yeah, you did. That because that was you and Dean and Matt going to school.
If I had the car there for a little while.
Yeah.
No, I don't think you did. No, you were just rewinding because we just saw those guys fighting. Remember, you fast forwarded through all this, but we didn't see it.
Oh, I rewound too much. That's why.
Yeah, well, we never saw this before because this is the home lake stuff.
Yeah. I fast forwarded it too far. Is this what you want to see, Mother?
I wasn't looking at Heidi. I don't care if I see it.
There.
There's the three of you.
Is that Grandma Doll?
No,
that's Grandma Orr.
See, they're going to school, getting ready for school.
This?
Matt, Lorraine, and Dean.
Matt and Dean that far apart?
Mm-hmm.
4 years?
Well, five, because see, there's 4.5 between you and Matt. And Dean was a year older. There.
Now, how far did they really have to walk to school?
Well, they went
a mile.
To the bus stop. It wasn't
one of those 12 miles in the snow, Lorraine?
No. If we followed the road, when it was muddy, we went across the field, but when it was muddy, you couldn't. It must be G.A. and Eugene.
Terrors.
Well, they were just boys.
They were married, both of them.
Now the next one's our family. There. Do you remember that car?
What car is that?
It's a Chevrolet that we had.
Dad's going to want to see this.
Oh, he's seen it.
Now, there.
Yeah, take his hat off and bow. Who says Mom has all the funny humor in here?
So it's Matt and Dave and Jack and me.
Look at Matt. Doesn't he think he's smart? Oh, wow, who's looking at me? Or Nancy not, and Nancy, there's Dave. And Matt.
That was Matt?
Mm-hmm,
you told
him. Yeah,
Is that you?
Yeah.
She's teasing those boys.
Look who's teasing who.
Look at that stick Steve, Dave was welding.
What?
Dave's got a stick he's throwing around. Lorraine, she's teasing all of them.
I'm doing a stand in there. They're the ones.
You walked right back into it, Missy. You were clear far away, didn't she? You saw it.
Well, they didn't have a stick.
Popular then.
There's Lorraine and Matt coming up.
School?
Matt went to a school where there was mostly Italian and Mexican kids. So they were all dark-haired, brown-eyed. And Brad was just, did you know I have white hair? When he saw his picture and it was white hair, it just astonished him. couldn't believe his hair was white.
See, we're older than probably all of those now, except maybe Grandma Orr.
I'm one. They were at our house, and somebody said, which of you girls is the oldest? And before anybody could say a word, Grandma said, well, line them up, and you can tell. Line them up and look at them, and you can tell. And, of course, Althea was really upset.
She's the oldest.
Yeah.
Grandma
Orr.
Yeah.
Her hair was just real, real long. And that's one of the boys.
Is that Jack?
Point it down, somebody says. Don't point it at people. Point it down.
That isn't Jack.
Oh, he's crying.
But you gave it to me.
Who's picking him up?
You.
Well, it must have been Jack.
Or you were loving somebody else's kid.
Yeah.
Don't point at the camera.
Yeah, that's what Daddy says. Point it down.
I want to point it at the camera.
Here.
I didn't even think, I never thought Jack was that heavy.
Mm-hmm. He was little, he was.
Must have been getting his teeth out.
Yeah.
Reading?
Whenever Ort was riding and working cattle on him.
Was he sports?
I seen Ort.
No, that's Dean. No.
Same one?
Yeah. If I did it again, I'd get one that had the VCR in it, because you ruin your camera making VCRs. Mother, what grade was I in when I went to that Doyle house? Or to the Doyle schoolhouse? Third? Fourth? Where would you read about it at?
In the library.
What, the U.S. Army had it?
No, Doyle had it. It was a business.
It was a teacher each year.
I should be able to see it. That house back there has been there for a long time, hasn't it? Where are they at?
Well, you'll have to see right up on top of those rocks. You can get a better view from the car over there. It says Joseph Doyle Settlement. Joseph Bainbridge Doyle was one of the builders of Fort Pueblo in 1842. He purchased 2 miles of the Wharfenaw Valley in 1859 from Vigil and St. Vrain and established his family here, building the large ranch House Casablanca with the lumber shipped from St. Louis. Doyle brought 600 acres under cultivation, built irrigation ditches, and established one of the first flour mills in Colorado. Huh. He brought the first school teacher into Colorado, O.J. Goldrick, to tutor his children. He was elected commissioner of Wharfenaw County and to the state council, as the state senate was then called. Aged remains of the Doyle era still stand near here. The Doyle Schoolhouse, one of the oldest burial grounds in Colorado, containing the gravestones of the Doyle family, early pioneers, and other members of the Doyle settlement.
So that's the grave. My battery be bad. Oh. Had to climb the hill. There's the road. On the way to Vertrees. I've got to conserve my battery. River. There's the top house. And there's the old barn. Butler Ranch. I feel like I'm hurrying because my batteries are going dead. hope we get to come back in August. My camera.
Man, they have, look that, look how they fixed that down under here.
Put a bridge. We're down at the farmhouse and we made a road and put a bridge in.
It's casing down there.
The rock house. Trails looking at the beginning of the wharf and all. My battery's gonna go dead in a minute. He's at the head of the wharf and all river. That's where I. Years were you here from? 67 to?
67.
She hasn't thrown away.
Who?
Who?
Melva Williams. She said she was gonna toss them.
Throw it? Oh, golly.
That's why.
You know,
her peonies.
Yes.
Yeah,
oh, here.
Yeah. She's got.
Do you want to get out of the way, Tiz?
Well,
it's blinking.
Yeah, it's working for a little while. I'll have to see. Maybe I didn't get a good charger on the other one.
Get over
it. Hi, Earlene.
Okay.
You're going to have to practice smiling now that you've got one.
You might not have,
Did they tell you after you charge it five times?
Oh, I don't know, some time ago. About 3 years ago.
There is no pieces out of it.
This battery seems to be working now. I must have got a bad charge on it.
Well, maybe you didn't get this plugged in just right. It might have been loose plugged.
Could be. That's too bad.
Yeah.
It would have taken a lot more.
Anybody want any coffee?
Can you bring your lapso out and show us what a lapso looks like?
Not yet.
Amen. That's all, folks.
Oh, you got to get the camera and he's gone.
Oh, three more. Stop. Three more. Now.
I haven't played this one in a long time. I might stumble through it.
Oh, well. What is it?
Paper Roses.
Oh, we don't. She wants us to sing one.
Go ahead, play it.
Paper Roses.
I'm liable to stumble through it because I haven't played it in a long, long time.
Go ahead and stumble through it.
Okay.
Thank you. There's a truck out on the four lane, a mile or more away. The whining of his wheels just makes it colder. He's an hour away from riding on your prayers up in the sky. 10 days on the road, barely gone. There's a fire softly burning, supper's on the stove. It's the light in your eyes that makes him warm. Sunshine made her cry. You felt the baby move just yesterday.
Hello, Mother.
Oh, honey, it's about time.
You're in the fashion show. Oh, Daddy. What? Oh, you wore that one. You gave in. He was going to wear the turquoise one, but we got this one.
Yes.
Is that the starburst one?
Yes. And that's how you feel like a continuous.
Still only about halfway, I'm gonna try it.
Not enough light? Isn't your light?
Right on, party, please. Right on, party, please. Dance, sir. And we're trying to get a war.
Bear, and that's new sister Debbie. And we're watching videos in New York. Are you ready?
Yeah, I do need a little more. I think I've got to somewhere a little bit more there than here. Okay, let's because every time everybody laughs about me taking measure my dome with a tape measure.
Looks like you'd know it by sight.
Well, she's pretty close every time.
Now, why wouldn't you let me get you a marble one with handles?
Honey, this had handles.
Well, I know, but they broke. And I was going to get you one that had handles. I don't know why you won't let me.
Anyway, see
is
there?
It 20 by 10?
It's just a teeny bit over 20, but when we roll it, it'll work. I have some now.
Does it make a difference to the flavor, Crisco?
It tastes different if you're going to really taste it.
I'm not too fond of it.
I use it when I do the crumbs for the top of an apple pie or something because it tastes a little more.
Well, I make my pie dough out of it.
Oh, do you?
Uh-huh. I kind of like that flavor.
I chicken out. I use the Pillsbury Already pie dough.
What, honey? Okay, you want to open it up for me, please.
Okay, watch yourself, Mama.
Oh, shoot.
Are they over-raised?
No.
What'd you do?
I should have put my foil on the bottom of my pan, because those are high and they're going to go out.
They're going to leak over a little, huh?
What foil?
Well, I've got it. I'll just stain my oven again.
Oh, how beautiful. North Pole Castle.
What does it play?
White Christmas. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
That is cute, Lynn. Steve wants him to jump. Throw a rock at him. There's the buildings for the main part of the ranch. There's the cattle guard. The butler sign's gone.
No, it's down to the south. See it? The two poles? That's where it is. Oh. Ditch.
Oh, it's bigger.
Keeps on going up?
Yeah, that's where the water comes from.
You must be able to get across the ditch over here where this road goes. Do they get across the ditch there?
I don't know.
Where that road goes down there?
I don't know. That's in my...
Graduated.
I got the house. I just want a picture of that with the rocks and the.
The Keith
this was
place.
Your kitchen, and that was your living room, and the bedrooms were all two bedrooms off over there. It was a four-room house.
You're following us.
Who made you do it?
You.
How?
All you have to do is walk, or you're gonna get cockaburs.
The old stove was always there.
Is that the old table?
And they didn't have the bathroom built in. We didn't have a bathroom.
You'll have to come and...
They did the two. They put a bathroom.
Built in a bathroom. It's leave here. That was a bedroom, and that was a bedroom.
Oh, well, how, what year did you make it in, Daddy?
Probably in the 50s.
In the 50s? We're in the round pasture.
Bird, you're on hand or camera.
Yeah. Yeah, I go through there about once a year.
Do you?
No, no, you're right. Here you go, Bird, you're on hand or camera.
Yeah.
Yeah, I go through there about once a year.
Do you?
One of the coaches down at school, his mom and dad. Oh.
We were at Linda's for the reception. Everything was wonderful until we got everything out.
Up there.
Why?
Mice?
Yeah.
After hearing her dinner conversation.
What, the clapper?
Yeah. Oh.
The clapper. Clap it on and clap it off. I'm going to hide it every day now to see if it works.
Oh, is that what you clap to?
It tells you where you have two appliances you can put to it. Two claps for one appliance and three claps for the other. It turns it on, turns it off.
There you know.
Isn't it
so you can sit in your chair and have your TV on or your light on?
Isn't it amazing what science has done?
Yeah.
Thanks, Kevin.
He's not sure whether you're going to exchange that.
Yeah, I like that.
Not.
Grandpa liked it too.
Yeah, Grandpa likes probably getting you. What's the difference?
Kevin, Ken.
When they're in their kitchen.
You know about this?
What?
You know about this? Oh, yeah, good. We were just talking about this. That is nice.
smoke yeah, detector.
We were just talking about getting another one. We needed another one.
We're hanging up now.
Another one? You got one?
We have one, but
when did you get that?
Years ago.
It's carbon monoxide?
This is carbon monoxide. Well, that's better yet. I think we need this.
Yes, with your kerosene.
Well, we don't have that anymore.
We don't use kerosene.
That is nice. Thank you. I was going to buy something, but I thought
you thought it was a fire alarm.
I was going to buy one, something like that, only I didn't know you could get those. I thought you'd have to get something to stick. Oh, boy. This is from Lorraine. I like that, too. That makes me smell nice, even when
that's what you get, too.
Well, that's what Lorraine gets.
All I have, she's gotten for me.
I'm getting better, Jack. That's 3 out of 3. So David and Debbie. Handmade from Apatiti, Russia.
Mm. Who's that from?
David and Debbie.
Oh, it's a fine.
Hand-painted lacquered brooch and clip earrings. Vorkita. Komi Republic, Russia. Oh, they're pretty, aren't they? Handmade.
So is there jewelry box?
And so is the box. We'll pass it around.
Brooch and earrings?
Yeah, brooch and earrings and the little box, jewelry box.
That's nice.
Thank you.
Russia.
Look through that. Make sure that it's not in the ceiling, would you please?
It's not even on.
Kevin.
Oh, me?
I don't know how to...
What's that one back there?
That's Kevin, or Karen.
Oh.
And Scotty.
That's her.
Yeah.
Do you go to first?
Well, we will now. We only go to first when we get coupons. When people give us coupons. To someone special, a wish for Christmas. Grace be to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. That's from Missy Orr. Is that your writing? Pat. Dear Grandpa and Grandma, we hope you are doing well. We would love to be with you at the Christmas time. We will have a kind of low-key holiday. The last few months have been busy, so we are ready to kick back, relax. Hope you all enjoy being together. Oh, Walmart. It'd be nice to go to Walmart without having to pay for it.
Yeah, nice.
Write a check.
Yes.
Yeah. I didn't know Walmart had gift certificates.
I think everybody does.
But you're like, where did those other coupons go? Well, maybe I better just keep it in this.
Pretty card.
Uh-huh. I need to keep this with the box when it comes back. Well, love to Mother and Dad from Jack and Lorraine. Through all the seasons, for so many reasons, you're thought of with love and joy. Have a very happy holiday. Well, I hate to tear it up. It's so pretty.
Paper's just out of this world. Oh.
You still got that thing out there.
I forgot to talk about it.
Yeah, you did, didn't you?
You're supposed to act surprised.
Oh my. A bread machine.
Well, now we have some fresh bread.
Now you won't have to knead and your hands won't hurt. We'll get rid of all that aggression.
Well. My goodness. Well, thank you. When you come down, I'll bake you some bread.
And the ticket's in the bottom in case you want to exchange it. That's
not. Cam has a ticket. What? I say Cam has a ticket in case you want to give it back to us next Christmas. I'll exchange mine for yours.
You want it? By that time, yours will be worn out, huh? How about that, Jack? Practice makes perfect, huh? Shall I open it up or just leave it like that? Let's just leave it like that. Be easier to handle. A dough maker. Okay,
you got another.
I have one more.
What does this say? Tomorrow?
This says
has two stars on it.
This says Mom from Steve and Debbie. Mom from Steve and Debbie.
Another coat. It's a coat you took back.
Oh my. Oh my. A sweater. Pretty, huh? Huh?
Oh.
Oh, for Pat.
If you knew it, why did you get it?
Well, I didn't know it till after I got it.
What is it, a nightgown?
No.
Oh. It's really pretty.
It's supposed to be a blouse.
But it really
is. Yeah, it is, but
you don't think I could, it can
fit? It's too small.
I don't think so, honey.
What's?
Depends on how they run.
She's mm-hmm. on a diet.
I'll tell you what size it is.
What?
Since you're on a diet, maybe it's pretty.
Oh, don't get smart. Do you think it's pretty?
Yeah.
I think it's really pretty. Mother, you have good taste. I don't know why you don't think you do.
I tell you, it doesn't matter. No matter what she wears, my mom looks pretty all the time.
Woo! I have to do that.
Desk calendar.
Here you go.
Is that where yours came from, Steve, this year?
Take a peek preview.
Oh, shame on you.
Everybody likes it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
On location with the swimsuit model, Sports Illustrated desk calendar.
When you get to heaven, use it for a gate ticket.
I'll have them. They'll be there live.
Who'd you get your plants?
Three white guys together. It's all Steve.
Both of them?
Well, this is a sympathy one for Dad, and this is a Mother's Day.
Did you get them same time? They deliver them at the same time?
Yeah, they deliver at the same time. He said the florist really liked him that day. He said he got two bouquets, and then he got a corsage for her mom.
Oh, from out there? It makes it harder if you do. And you hold your thread underneath. Oh, no, you put it around your fingers.
It has to go over and come through. Use your middle finger.
I should be behind you so it would...
I can't do it fast. It's because you don't do it enough. What I mean is... Well, yeah, she told him.
Sure.
But you see, when she had trouble with that with that car, she was renting it. She finally took it back. She says, "You give me another car. I'm not driving this one back out." And of course, the sludge. Look at that. Look at those sludge. Not so much. Probably not much.
Still
clucking?
No.
Yeah, like when it's still
I've
rolling,
heard
it's
still
pretty
clucking. Good, but it's... David, good barbecue. Stephen did good rice. Matt helped set the table. Debbie helped the dishes.
Is that a bread dish?
Yeah.
We're getting to be a family that works together.
Okay. All right.
That's a good line. Dave, he tries taking pictures. Puts his hands in the right spot.
Yes, hello.
Oh, hello.
Are you tallest, Jack?
Maybe.
I think so.
He's got more beard than...
Oh, it doesn't like the light on this one. Yeah, I like that one better. Okay. Angel?
Number one brother.
Angel?
Number one brother.
The baby.
I forgot you had a beard.
Number two brother. Number three brother.
You probably saw the video.
Number four brother.
Oh boy, now we got a real shadow, Jack.
And the cause of it all. I think they just wanted one of the graves.
Sure do.
They are very pretty.
Oh no!
Oh, I know you love it.
Oh yeah, we do. That's the thing about those cameras. They're mighty quiet.
Sneaky.
That's what they call a lot of books.
Oh, the cameras? Yeah. Get caught. You're all right. That maybe would go on the camera better than the other one. Maybe.
Steve is the biggest.
He was the biggest.
Yeah,
he is. He's our teddy bear. He's best. Hi. David sent some. Okay, the mother of course came, brought it up.
Only a heavy tackle by Tyrone saved a big gain out to the 45.
Do you have any boxes in the shed, Ken, that Angel will fit in? Hi, Daddy. Is he sleeping?
Hi.
Hello, Kevin. He does have a face. It has been in the TV or in a book the whole vacation. Had to read 7 C.S. Lewis books. Now he's all educated. Okay. Let's see your muscles, Kevin. See where it is.
You want a program or not? You guys ready to start or what?
Me?
All right. Start it off. All right. I thought I just did it.
Huh?
I thought I just did, but all right. Here we go. You ready?
I'm here too.
Since last year.
It's been a little while.
That's about right, too. You took your music with you. Did you use it all? Noticed anything? The banker's eyes? How about the CPA? There's something special on there you guys should be noticing. I can see it from here.
Money.
It's close, but that's not it. Close, but that's not it.
Lights up every time. Really shows up.
Is it one that he stuck in?
Mm-hmm.
That was Snow and Klondike ornament. I should tell you all my special ornaments.
Well, yeah, I didn't understand what you meant when you said, getting pictures to your ornaments.
Thank you.
pretty neat.
Oh, yeah, it went to home.
And I used to have a saddle, but I think I gave it to you.
Alarm clock says about 6:20. 6:18.
Oh, my turn?
I saw it.
Did
you? Yeah.
Now, once you learn how to do that, you can do every one of them. They'll come right in.
Who's that one from?
Jack.
Can of nuts.
Uh-huh.
I hate to open packages when they get...
Now, I get to keep it because you lied. Said you could do it without breaking it, so I get to keep it.
Yeah, break.
I was trying to get it out.
Well, I mastered that. Yeah.
Pretty big package, Mother.
Ice tea pot.
How nice.
Aaron,
thank you.
Jack.
Hey.
That's a big one.
I
don't
have tea.
Yeah.
Two times.
Huh?
Didn't you
thank
see
you, Jack.
What did you
give him for his birthday? You gave him a teapot thing?
Yeah.
Well,
they,
it was a little one.
Huh?
It was a two-quart.
What, is like a skier or something there?
She's been wanting one for a long time.
Is this a skier?
Oh, where'd you get it at?
That was from Target, so.
This is the big one.
Keep the big one and give the little one to...
I've definitely mastered this.
Karen. You can get more than one.
I got two. I got one without even knowing what it was.
Well, I lost my pencil.
Kevin, can you get Grandma another pencil, please? Took the charge card and went down Castle Rock Outlet.
He did?
Yeah.
Who did?
Yeah.
I don't know who foot the bill, though.
Wow.
Oh.
Didn't you see that big check on his desk? Oh, it's my turn, isn't it? No, it's Jack's turn. The next baby. I hope we're getting you when we do that.
Another Kim King. What flavor is this one?
I think that one is the strawberry and the other one is the raspberry. I declare dessert is about like that. And it's eclair. About $5, but about 6 people can eat it. Mm-hmm. Now you can listen to your tapes in stereo. Not that extravagant.
Well, thank you very much.
You can take it in by your bed, and you can take it by your...
Yeah, we can take Arlene's back now.
What is hers like?
Oh, I don't know. It's a...
Is it just a little box that you push?
It's something like this.
Is it a radio?
Uh-huh.
Does it have a radio on it?
It's a radio and tape player.
No, that's supposed to be stereo, so it should make your tapes sound pretty good. And if you want to, you can do it on batteries if you want to carry it around.
Bad from Steve.
Uh-oh, Kevin.
Could be bad news. Huh?
Could be bad news.
I don't think it is.
Was it a Western?
Is it a record?
That's all your record?
He knows your record player's broken.
Hey, look at that, boy.
calendar.
Rodeo days. Look on the back.
Cowboy calendar.
Rodeo. Open the cab.
You want to read it, Dad?
No.
You are the parents I received the day I wed your son. And I just want to thank you both for the things that you have done. You have given me a gracious man with whom to share my life. You are his loving parents and I his lucky wife. You used to pat his little head and now I hold his hand. You raised in love a little boy, then gave to me a man. Deb and Steve.
What nice. Date? Yeah.
She made it.
Is it crocheted or? Is it painted? Pass it down. That's neat.
That's a clever little thing, isn't it?
Did she make up the poem? Or?
I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah, that's pretty special. You're not talking yet, huh, Daddy?
No. Pretty neat. Looks like it's so.
Yeah, that's pretty special.
Pretty.
You're not talking yet, huh, Daddy?
No. Pretty neat. Looks like it's so.
What is?
I'm sure. She spent many an hour on that. I'm sure she did. Beautiful.
She's embroidered it.
She's what?
She's embroidered it. It's cross stitch.
Uh-huh. Yeah, she's beautiful work, isn't it?
Yeah, they're really good at 6/25/94.
That was
their wedding day. They're good at doing those.
Yeah, they're very creative people.
Yeah.
All right.
See what you're talking about.
They're there.
Let me see it. Pull it up there, buddy. Oh, come on. Get the lump on it.
You gotta go this way. There. That's the way you do it.
You gotta get the other side.
Do it again.
Side.
Do it the side way.
Do it on this
do
side.
Do the other side.
Do it on your right.
Yeah.
Do it on your nursing.
Get that.
Get that muscle up there.
I want you to squeeze it like
there's
this.
There's not much there.
Yeah. What were you bragging about?
Come on, squeeze that up there.
That's not where the strength is, though.
You need to do there. Your things to work.
Yeah, your triceps.
Yeah, I got a little bit of tricep.
Kevin.
From Ken?
Ken. Know about this? Oh, yeah! Now I got the powder to go with it. I love this stuff.
Will this last you a year?
Yes, probably. I ought to have it from or until a birthday or something. See, I just opened my last package, too.
You already gave me a present.
Thank you very much.
You too. This is Santa present. Who's that from, Grandpa?
Daddy from Lorraine.
There's your peaches and cream. Is that a blue one over there, too?
Yeah,
is that
he's
a blueberry?
Got the blueberry. You can have it.
Really should be from Ken. He's the one who suggested it, but I took credit for it.
Oh, good.
I
That's what he wanted. He's been grumbling for one of those for a little, ever since he got his car.
Yeah. It's 86, too, in here. You're good. Just what I need.
Is it? I told him pickup, but it says van.
Yeah, it's
then I think it's what
Ranger.
It's a Ford Ranger. That's
Bronco.
What mine is.
Same
thing. Bronco.
Let's see, shop manual?
Yeah.
Are you through, Kevin?
Yeah.
You got a lot of notes. You got a lot of paper to write on now, Mom.
A Memory a Day series.
Uh-oh.
Grandpa, Scott, and Karen. Uh-oh. Spring. I see a spring there. Tell me your memories.
See, Grandpa's bearing Grandma.
Grandpa, tell me your memories. Memory of the Day series.
Tells you what to write. That should be easy.
What was your day and date of birth? Where were you born? Do you know any other circumstances of your birth? Who was triggers?
She wants these back.
Evidently so. What kind of present is that?
What was your father's date and place of birth? Gee whiz. A lot of these questions I never even know.
A lot of work to you look.
Just make an X.
Lorraine from Kim. Did we have these downstairs? Where'd you get those?
What allowance did you get? Well, honey, there wasn't a word like that in the dictionary when we were growing up.
What?
Allowance. What allowance did you get?
Oh, a massage.
We got our dinner on the plate, boy. That was pretty good.
It's Kevin's last stock, and he's a senior in college, and this is it. 9:30, he hasn't even got up to check it out. And he won't for a while yet. Mother's Christmas centerpiece. Oh, we are ready. The famous candied sweet potatoes and dressing and ham and corn and turkey and mashed potatoes and Christmas salad. Ken's regular sweet potatoes over there and hot rolls. And of course the TV with Kevin watching it. Boy, they're really farming the farmhouse. See, I used to live down there in that farm at Brown House.
Which one?
Brown House was down there.
No Brown House anymore.
Look at the car coming. Every day we'd come out here and get our mail up there. Then. There's the barns.
Sissy, we just had a door here.
You don't want the picture? This wasn't as big, was it?
Is it
Nicole Simpson?
Has it always been that big?
We just had a door.
Cow.
Yeah. A cow?
Cow kicked the you. Gate. The gates. Oh, broke my nose like right off my face. It was like laying over. I mean, there is no question about it.
There's the big window of it, Jack and Brooke.
So were you bending down?
No, I shut the gate on her.
That used to be the old office of the same floor.
Well,
with the rain.
We're from LA. We're from Whittier.
What do you see in it?
I mean, just
there we are at the Butler Ranch, and that's the headquarters, and they're all walking down the hill, Mother and Karen and Scott. And the deer flies are really biting. And there's the barn. We've got some horses in it. I'll have to go in and see the brands. There's Daddy looking over the ensilage pit that he put there. And they tore down the rock machine shed and put a metal one up. Well, that shed's been there a long time. That was there. I could look out my room and look into that shed. It was so exciting. That shed was there. Did you hear that horse? That felt good. That barn seemed to me like a big barn, too. Now it's pretty small.
I can take one with the torch. That you want to scoot out.
What's the matter?
Oh.
Give him some light.
There's a lazy white slash. Oh.
Boy, you spread that one all over.
Daddy, that was an AVA. What did we call that?
Oh, that's your AVA right there.
Is that what we called it?
Yeah. Yeah, AVA.
And the two-bar box.
Yeah.
It's open A. Well, really.
Right, what was there. Ord's called?
Bar lazy B slice.
Yes, sir. Now, what's all this?
Brand.
Oh, they are?
Yeah.
Actually, on the count there.
Oh, that's why.
There's a couple of them.
Couple what?
Grasshopper.
Huh? Listen, he, or I mean Mr. Shepherd's house. He lived there and drove the bus.
That was back down the only door of the house.
And it started there. And there's the girl.
See it better.
It's a foundation.
Binoculars. Be careful
with that cactus.
And that's where Matt fell over the side.
It's a meter. And they measured the water that they took out.
How come there's no water?
Well,
from dry.
Really? Yeah.
You see that high cement bank there?
Yeah.
I've seen water 3 and 4 feet higher than the old, that's the top of that
it
cement
was all
bank.
Over. Wrong with it?
There's a pole I can't.
They've fixed it so you can't open it.
Yeah.
I mean, you could. You'd have to cut the wires.
Yeah.
I don't think they'd look too kindly on that.
See, this is good, Sarah.
Looking at the cow patties. You can tell we're city people.
Yeah.
You can't smell it at all? Do you smell the pine tree?
Yeah, they look like a
bird
swallow.
Has that fireplace always been in here? I don't remember the fireplace.
This is
the canyon edge. Yeah. We'll go look down. Daddy opened up the old gate.
Top one, so my arm doesn't stop. It hyperextends.
The top,
I can't
go closer.
See in there. I'm not even sure if I've got.
He's getting ready to run.
There he is, I guess.
Okay.
There he's going.
Yes.
No, he's not.
Too thorned it.
Well, why? Let him stay.
I want to let him run. Well, watch
just
him run on the camera.
Just give the motor a little.
He's not scared. There he goes.
Dad. Don't they not hear that over
there? They ain't hearing that anywhere, Mama.
Shoo! There he goes, Karen. You got him?
There he goes.
Now jump. Bump. Okay, let's race him.
There he goes.
Go, Daddy, go.
Well,
Is Scott, in?
The Rock House. One of the boxes built. Furnished. Towels. It's like somebody was sitting at the desk eating popcorn. Mice droppings in there like nobody's been in there. To the Hog Ranch.
Daniel Quartet, Jake sang with many other groups until finally connecting.
Mama watching her Geether videos that she likes.
Quartet from Atlanta, Georgia. From then on, it was history.
Yeah.
After his tenure with the Statesman in the Imperial.
Are those all Gaither songs?
No, these are the praises that came up.
Yeah, that came up.
What woke us up at 6 o'clock this morning, only there's one guy that really shifts gears in front and makes a total wreck. Well, you should.
20 after. By what? About 16? 15?
As many times you've done it, you probably.
Yeah,
in the microwave?
I usually melt it, but I told you it's got so much water in it anymore.
Yeah.
Margarine has lots of water in it.
You don't use butter?
Well, I wish I could, but it's expensive.
Yes.
And it's fat.
And then,
bigger ones make bigger noises. Bigger, that's supposed to be really good to use in these. You just, well, it was dark, you know, those Cinnabons when you look at them, but there's some of them that say have special cinnamon oils and stuff. But I don't know where you'd get them.
Well, you'd probably buy it. But...
About 5 minutes, I'd say about six.
I
missed out on that one.
Well, no.
Did you put raisins on there?
Yep. This one, yes.
Yeah. So you put the nothing. Oh, you sprinkled cinnamon on top of the brown sugar?
Yes.
I wanted to see how heavy you did the cinnamon.
Pretty heavy.
You have to, yes, after you watch.
I put a lot of cinnamon. People like cinnamon, and you don't get them in your rolls that you buy because it's expensive.
June the 21st, 1996. On June the 20th, 96, I wasn't going to go to Pueblo with Scott or Karen. I thought they might want to get away for a while. And I was going to go down next Tuesday. Karen encouraged me to go, so I quickly packed and went with them down to Pueblo. They wanted to see the ranch, the Butler Ranch, so Mother had gone out to see the lady who lives in the headquarters house. She stayed and talked to her while Daddy and Bob went to the back end of the ranch. We got down to Pueblo about 2:45 or 3 p.m. The traffic in Colorado Springs was yucky. Mother and Daddy greeted us and supper was in the oven. Meatloaf with Mexican flavor. She had added some salsa scallop potatoes and beans. It was yummy. About 5 p.m. we left the dishes, which is very unusual for Mother to do, and went out to the ranch. At first, Scott and Karen were in the back of the pickup and Daddy and I in front with Mom in the King cab. We drove to the corner to get gas and the dust was blowing in, so I rode in back with Mom in the King cab and Daddy, Scott, and Karen had a tight fit in the front. Mother and my knees were scrunched so that she put her knee first, then my knee, then hers, and then mine. We had a perfect fit. We laughed about our arrangement. I wish I had a picture of it. Every time we got in and out, we giggled about it. It was hard for Mother to get in and out, and me too, and she pretty much stayed in the King cab except for long excursions. We headed out towards the ranch and showed Karen the Utz and told about the dust storm, pointed out Mrs. Dawson's and my first piano lessons, the Broadacre where David fell off out of the car going over the bump. I thought it was Jack, but Mom said no. Several new houses out there now. Showed them where the old mailboxes were and the Vertrees Lake where we tried to go swimming a time or two. Stopped at the hill, at the top of the hill to look over the Butler. The cattle guard and the old Butler sign are now gone. Pointed out to where the brown house was. We were invited into the headquarters house and I had my video and took scenes of the big picture window that Jack broke and the fireplace and the furnace outlet that blew your skirts up and the old brown spotted tiles are still in the office area or the and then the kitchen too and the basement. It all seemed so much smaller. We went down to the barn and went inside and looked at all the brands all along the wall. Daddy's Lazy Y/O and the AVA and the 2-bar box and Ord's brand were all there. Looked at the ensilage pit that Daddy worked with and the metal barn and the farmhouse is no longer there. Went to the picket corrals and across Iron Springs trap to the Keith place. All that remains is the foundation. We were all in shorts except for Dad and the horse flies were biting like crazy. I had a can of off and we really used it. Saw the Gerton's house and Mr. Shepherd's house. He was the bus driver and we looked out over the Orphanage. Daddy showed us the level of the flood and where the ditch was for irrigation and the dam and the old flume. We went to the middle pasture, the round pasture, looked at the windmills, stopped and looked at the feed trough that Daddy built in the 50s. We went on to the pole line camp. We tried to drive up to the house, but the gate was wired shut and we had to straddle the wire fence. Someone remarked how well Mother straddled the fence. She said she could do it. The door was barely open. The door to the Keith place. Not the Keith place. The door was hard to open and the porch roof was falling in. We managed to get inside and we took another picture of the stove that we always take when we're there. Mother told the story of going to the door to answer a knock and of Mr. Sample and his gun and holster scaring her to death. She also told him of the rain and the hail on the tin roof and all the noise. Karen stirred up a bat, so we left and we went to the side of the canyon and threw rocks down and listened to them hit the pool of water. Karen found a snake skin, so we didn't stay too long. We tucked about the stage coach ruts and saw the jackrabbits and saw antelope and talked about how they went through the fence and not over. Went back to headquarters and over the new bridge to the rock house. We showed them where the bumper gate was and told them about forging the river in the car and on foot and the quicksand in the river. Mother was getting tired and she stayed in the car while we took a picture of the rock house. It was falling down now. Daddy pointed out how long it was with 3 chimneys and it had 12 bedrooms. The bunkhouse is half gone now and the outhouse still stands a bit. We went up to the top of the hill to see the new Spanish house someone built and does not use. Mom got out and they all saw a road runner, so they said. We had never seen one there before, but Karen was wearing soft tennis shoes and she stepped in a cactus. So Mother helped her pick it out, and we looked in the windows of the fancy house. I was still picking cactus out of her foot a day or so later. Started back home and stopped at the Doyle Schoolhouse. Mom stayed in the pickup, and Karen and Scott got out to read the sign about the Doyle Schoolhouse and how the first teacher in Colorado taught there. There was a pickup parked nearby, and we didn't think much about it until Karen came running back because she started to peek in the window, and a girl's voice said to come in and join them. It was starting to get dark, so we went on home. We did the dishes, and Mom put on the Gaither video, Just Jake, and we also watched Turn Your Radio On for a little bit. I'd given her an early Mother's Day present of four of the Gaither videos because she enjoyed them so much, and I'm so glad I did that. Scott and Karen watched the videos right along with Mom and I, and even though it's not their favorite, Southern Gospel isn't their favorite, they stayed awake and right along with us. Mother had us fast forward to try to find a guy that she really liked singing a song. I wish I could remember the name of it, but I haven't been able to remember it yet. She told me she really liked that song, Death Ain't No Big Deal. We sang songs and Karen played. I played the keyboard for a little bit, and then we all sang together. Mother whistled until 1 a.m. Still wasn't sleepy, but we decided to go to bed. Mom insisted I sleep in their bedroom, and she and Dad went downstairs. I don't think she slept very well as usual. She was up early. I heard noises about 5 or so, and trucks going by woke me up for good at 5:45. We had a nice oatmeal breakfast, and she started making cinnamon rolls for us to take home warm. She laughed and talked and told stories and seemed to be doing okay, although Mother doesn't ever complain. Her best friend Beulah down there in Pueblo didn't know she had arthritis that hurt her so bad. The night before, as we ate supper, she told us stories. I remember her telling that I was planning on leaving that day on the train to go to Omaha to nurse's school. I told her that I probably shouldn't go as they didn't have the money for my tuition. It wasn't very much, as my working was part of that school bill, but she said God will provide. And not too much later, there was a knock on the door, and Frank from the bus garage was there talking about the new kindergarten route so that the little kids didn't have to go so early and stay so late and ride the bus with the high school kids. She asked him who was going to drive the bus, and he handed her the keys and said, "You are." I had tears just listening to her story. She asked me if I remembered that, and I had a hard time answering her. I remember parts of it. She drove the bus 2 times a day for the kindergarten route, and later on drove the other route too. Talked about how Steve was in the car seat, in the seat directly behind her. I still am amazed how a little kid got along like that. He was probably a year or so old. She said it was no problem. She said he kept the kids entertained, and then they entertained him. She said she remembered once he did act up, and she took him off the bus and paddled him. And she said she got back on the bus, and she was amazed at how good and quiet every single kid on the bus was all the way home. I'm hoping Karen and Scott can remember. Peaches, potato salad from scratch, of course, veggies, cookies, and hot cinnamon rolls. We cleaned up and left for home around 2 p.m. It was getting cloudy, a lightning storm. It was popping and hitting close. It was a hurried goodbye as I was giving her a hug, and she said, "Wait," and ran in and got her checkbook and wrote out a check for Scott's graduation present. That was the last check she ever wrote on Saturday, June 22nd.